How did you find the story?
It was curious. I mean, I've said now, I think, three times that I was never going to write another book about Wall Street, and they keep walking in the door, these stories. So this started when I got interested in the story of Sergei Alenikov, a Russian computer programmer who had left Goldman Sachs, mailed himself some computer code. He was a high-frequency trading programmer at Goldman Sachs, and was pretty instantly arrested by the FBI and ended up being sentenced to years in jail and spent a year in jail before his conviction was overturned. And I just followed that story in the paper.
And where did you think that story would lead you? Did you look and say, if somebody would do this, there must be a lot of money involved and something is going on here about those codes if Goldman Sachs was so concerned about losing them?
Yeah, so I had two thoughts about it. One was when they arrested him, the prosecutor said that he should be denied bail. He should be kept in prison because this code that he took, if it gets into the wrong hands, can be used to manipulate or undermine global financial markets. And I thought to myself, Goldman Sachs is the right hands? I mean, you know, like how much worse could the hands get for the code? And then I thought, you're telling me there's computer code that can be used to sink the global financial markets? How could that be? What is this stuff, this high-frequency trading? And then when he was sentenced to the 6-year or 7-year prison sentence, and you saw this financial crisis come and go with which Goldman Sachs had had a lot to do, and you see that the one person from Goldman Sachs who gets sent to jail after the financial crisis is the guy that Goldman Sachs wants to put in jail, all that seemed to me material. I didn't know where it was going to lead. But the first question, of course, I had after I got in touch with Sergei Alenikov and he agreed to talk to me and tell me his story and let me tell his story was, what is high-frequency trading? I mean, the term gets thrown around, but like a lot of Wall Street creations, it gets created and everybody wants to pretend like they understand what it means, but in fact, nobody really understood what it meant. And it was a term of art that really only entered into the public discourse when Sergei Alenikov was arrested. I mean, he was described as a high-frequency trading programmer and said, oh yeah, there must be something called a high-frequency trading programmer. But it was never explained. So I needed someone to explain that to me. And that led me to the subject. The subject, because what I did is I called some investor friends and I said, do you know what high-frequency trading is? And they said, kind of, sort of, but the person who's walked through our office and has explained this world to us, and it is more shocking than you know, is Brad Katsuyama.
They actually said that.
Yeah.